afternoon.
Password and username.
If that's it's valid, then you can also connect to the cloud server. Then after this, both existing and non-existing user are getting authorized by the admin, they can have the functions of downloading and viewing and saving the file. Here we have the server flowchart. In the server, we have the admin login, where the admin has its own username and password. If he enters the, if it is valid, it will connect to the cloud server, and if it is not valid, it will directly send its unauthorized server.
Ibrahim, you are talking to the world.
Yeah, after the admin login, he will have the functions such as add new user, restricted IP address, and available resources, hacker information, and available resources. So now, in restricted IP address, if suppose any user we want to admin wants to stop the authentication or wants him to not access the file, he can restrict his IP address and he can make the user not to access the file. We have the function in this restricted IP address. And available resources, the admin will be able to see all the file system which he is storing in the cloud, which is making the users to access. Where he can hit, either view, either remove, or either he can add the new file. So we have the use case diagram. Use case diagram is the user has the authentication for login, access to the resource, and show the files. Whatever files that it will be shown is, his authenticated files will be shown to him after he logins. And admin has all the functions of this all: login, access to resource, block and block the IP address, show the files, and record the hacker's behavior. And this is now data security architecture. We have the user login. User are two types. First, as I said, it's a brutal architecture, user and client and the admin. So when the admin logins, he'll be able to see the restricted IP address, the files which are there in the cloud, which he's creating. So he has the option of add, view and remove. Same for the restricted IP address, he has the add and remove. And if the user logins, and if suppose the admin has restricted his access on the particular file, then his and if the client tries to access that same file, which is restricted, that information, if he is trying again and again, like if the file is restricted and he is trying to access the same file again and again, that his information of IP address and time will be saved in the hacker's information in the type of log file, which is in the admin's control. It will be seen only to the admin. Like I have shown for the admin. Now the modules will be carried on by my friend, most same.
Now we speak about the modules. Firstly, there are the client module. In this module, the client sends a query to the admin or server. Based on the query, the admin server sends the corresponding file to the client. So what we understand is, when a user or client, he wants to access some files from the server, he first gives the query to the admin. The admin then provides the file to the client. Next, we have the system module. And under the system module, we have users, cloud service provider, and an optional third party auditor. Firstly, are the users. And the users who have data to be stored in the cloud and rely on the cloud for data computation consists of both individual consumers and organizations. Now, users are basically people like us. So there are different types of users, like individual users or consumers, like companies and all. We usually, what we do is we store data in the cloud and we for our personal users. Next, we have cloud service provider. The cloud service provider has significant resources and expertise in building and managing distributed cloud system, cloud storage servers, owns and operates live cloud computing systems. What a cloud service provider does is he behaves as a medium between the user and the cloud server. He manages the cloud server and has total control over the cloud computing system. Next, we have the third party auditor, an optional PPA who has expertise and capabilities that users may not have. It's trusted to access and expose risk of cloud storage services on behalf of the user's equipment. What the PPA does is it actually provides a security for the user. For example, if there is an untrusted server in the untrusted modify